The Alfa Romeo 155, introduced in 1992, remains a controversial model in the marque's history. To understand why, please follow me on this little trip back in time. Work on the 155 started shortly after Fiat's takeover of Alfa Romeo, making it the first completely new Alfa to be developed in this new era. Trouble is that it kind of showed. Contrary to the successful 164, which only shared the floor plan with its Fiat Lancia sisters and competed in a market sector where Alfa had never really had a strong presence, the 155 not only shared its entire body structure with the Fiat Tempra, but replaced the much-loved Alfa 75. Compared to the 75, the 155 was indeed a massive improvement in passenger comfort and refinement, but that didn't stop loyal buyers from feeling shortchanged. Consequently, the 155 actually lost customers to Alfa Romeo, despite the model's successes on the European racetracks. Having withdrawn Lancia from rallying in 1991, the Fiat Group redirected the people and resources that dominated rallying towards touring car racing. The 155 V6 Ti that, to the surprise of many, won the 1993 DTM Championship had little in common with the showroom model, but nevertheless remains one of Alfa Romeo's most outstanding racing winners. In 1994, Alfa Romeo launched the limited run 155 1.8 liters Silverstone. It was no faster, but came with a bolt-on spoiler package specifically developed for the British Touring Car Championship, which the 155 duly won that same year. 30 years on, the 155 is slowly starting to be considered collectible, especially the rare Q4 models, built until 1996 using the engine and running gear from the legendary Delta Integrale. The first series of the 155 was produced between January 1992 and March 1995. All its petrol engines were purebred Alfa ones, manufactured in the Arese factory near Milan and then sent to the ex-Alfa Sur plant near Naples, where the 155 was made. The 155 Series 2 models are often called wide body because of their subtly enlarged wheel arches, necessary to cover the car's widened track. This, together with a quicker steering rack, was done to make the 155 more rewarding to drive. The Series 2 models also saw the progressive introduction between 1995 and 1996 of the new generation of twin-spark 16-valve engines. However, the older 8-valve units soldered on, probably to get rid of stock, until the 155's demise in 1997.